My pleasure. Many of you who do not know me, I'm Ron Owens. I pastor the New Hope Baptist Church in Metuchen and a good friend of Ellen's. And we have come here to be a blessing to her, but also we have come not to memorialize a death, but to celebrate a life. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Yes.
Bill, brother.
We are here because Bill lived a full life, a tremendous life, and a wonderful life. And he touched each of us in a very special way. Truly, we can say that he did not live in vain. A father, an educator, surely a man who not only molded the minds of his students, but influenced all of us in such special ways. And so today we want to celebrate. Turn to your neighbor and say, we're celebrating today.
It says recording.
Amen.
Amen.
We want you to enjoy the services and enjoy being together, because this is what Bill would have liked. I'm sure that he would not want us to be sad and be bad. And of course, when we cry, you know, we're at our ugliest state when we cry. So we want everybody to put a smile on their face. And Bill is looking down from wherever he is. And we know that he's going to be happy to see all of us here to support Ellen and the family. Amen. And so I want us, if you can, to put your hands together and give a round of applause for Bill Ward, and surely for the life that he's lived. Now, I am also aware that some of you don't have the melanin in your skin that I have. And so we don't want anybody to sunburn out here for any reason at all. And so we're going to try our best to make sure the time that we spend here will honor Bill, but also be considerate of everybody, including Ellen. And so I invite you to just sit back or stand back and relax as Ellen comes now to share with us a little portion of Bill Ward and his life. And I know she can tell it like nobody else can.
Amen.
Here, here.
Amen.
I'm so thrilled to see you all. It is wonderful. This is the final version. There has been many. In the words of Cahil Gibran, your living is determined not so much by what life brings to you as by the attitude you bring to life. Not so much by what happens to you as by the way your mind looks at what happens. These are the earthly remains of Bill Ward, which we are burying today as we return him to his parents and ancestors who loved him. We ask that they accept him into their everlasting world, but we will never bury the spirit of Bill Ward, for he will never be forgotten. He is in our hearts, in our minds, in his children, every day. Bill was an original, no disputing that. He was passionate about his causes. He cared about being a scientist, a professor, a Democrat, a Yankee fan, an environmentalist, a maker of mulch, a lover of music and art. But it better be his kind of music and his kind of art.
Didn't I say that?
And God help anyone who interrupted him while he was telling a story. And he cared about family in his own absent-minded professor way. He was a devoted son, brother, husband, father, grandfather, and uncle. Bill was born on March 19, 1942, the year Harrison Ford, Barbara Streisand, Carole King, Stephen Hawking, and Joe Biden were also born. Gas cost 20 cents a gallon, a new car cost $920, and a movie ticket was 30 cents. For Frank and Betty Ward, the birth of William Warren Ward was enough to give them hope for a brighter future in spite of World War II. Much to his father's dismay, he was an overachiever. Frank couldn't fathom all the years Bill committed to school while getting his Bachelor of Science and Master's degrees at the University of Florida, his PhD from Johns Hopkins, and his postdoctoral from the University of Georgia. But Betty got it, and she was a champion always to all three of their children, wherever their lives took them. Bill was a brother to Bev and Brad. He was an inspiration to them and cared about them deeply. It's probably no accident that they too became educators. He was an uncle to nephews Bernard, Jimmy, Tommy, and Dana, and bonus uncle to Ari, Kara, Kim, Susie, Allison, Stephen, and Holly. We made special trips to Massachusetts to see family members perform in plays and to celebrate holidays and special occasions. Family get-togethers in Florida would often include some kind of board or ball game with the holidays. Whenever he could, Bill would play softball. He bragged that at one point he was in four different leagues. If he could have had a dream career, it would have been baseball player. He was a father by his first wife to his son Randy and daughter Jenny, and at age 51, he became father to our daughter Melanie. He became father-in-law to Evelyn, Mike, and Adam. All of his children made him proud. We marveled about how special each one was. Randy, with his talent for musical performance and technology. Jenny, who was the glue who held the family together and was loved by everyone. And Melanie, who was smart, sweet, creative, and caring. Bill was grandfather to Ryan, Brandon, Tyler, Jenna, and Nicholas, and a huge fan of their cheerleading sports and theater endeavors. Bill took the deaths of his parents and daughter Jenny hard. His father was killed instantly in a car accident. 6 years later, when his mother became very ill and died, it was a huge loss for him. She had... always been the most supportive person in his life, and she laughed at his jokes. When Jenny died suddenly of a cerebral hemorrhage, we were all in kind of a shock we never got over. Because you're never as vulnerable as you are when you lose a family member. He was brother-in-law to Ron, Diane, Ruthie, and Barry. He had a special bond with each one. Ron, a kindred spirit, was a comfort while Bill's mother was dying in the hospital. Diane was always hospitable when we visited and they laughed together. Ruthie and Barry knew him well enough that they created a song in his honor for his 75th birthday. Best of all, Barry always greeted Bill on our arrival at the Cape with a glass of Merlot. Mr. Bill was a loving husband and understood how important family was to me, and he was wonderful about sharing my love of music and theater. He never failed to tell strangers how we met doing
Pirates of Penzance
in community theater. Our first trip together was magic. We went to England for a symposium and talk he presented in London, and then traveled to Penzance on the southern coast of Cornwall, where he collected a stone from the beach. As a surprise, on Valentine's Day, he gave the stone to me mounted in a shadow box with an engraved plate reading Penzance, July 1989. He surprised me again the following year with a stay at a B&B at the shore in Spring Lake for the first birthday of mine that we celebrated together. And although a serious academic, he was not all nerd. On our honeymoon cruise, he dressed up as Dolly Parton for the talent show. Bill was a professor and educator at Rutgers University for 42 years and never stopped learning. He would often say, "I love going to work and I love coming home." For 16 or more years, he spent 2 weeks every summer at the University of Washington's Friday Harbor Labs in the Puget Sound, catching and processing thousands of jellyfish for his pioneering research on green fluorescent protein, a key tool in molecular biology. Don't ask me about it. The research at Friday Harbor played a big role in his award-winning green fluorescent protein work and also contributed to his unique jellyfish art, which you will be seeing later. Over the years, in addition to his regular teaching, he taught hundreds of industry professionals with his short... Sorry. courses, short courses, and designed and instructed a course for gifted and talented pre-college students, many of who came from out of state for the course. He always had time for his students. As much as Bill loved his science, he would impress the art part of arts. Good for a Bostonian, right? And sciences to the kids. He had a talent show at the end of every summer session where each kid had to do something: sing, dance, recite poetry, tell jokes, do magic. Bill would bring a boombox to class and needed little encouragement to sing a few songs himself. He often brought a team of student helpers to Friday Harbor, and they would rotate working around the clock, catching jellyfish, processing them, and then cooking meals and sleeping. It became like a little commune for those 2 weeks. By the time I came on the scene, Bill was still making the trips to Friday Hub, but the work wasn't as intense. I suppose that's when his mind relaxed enough to allow him to think of jellyfish as art. Literally, taking a jellyfish and imprinting it on paper. In 2004, Melanie and I accompanied him for a special symposium that he headed up. Scientists worldwide joined in. We were given an apartment and entertained casually. My clearest recollections were of a boat trip with all the attendees and a scientist named Neil Stewart playing the guitar in our apartment. Everyone singing along, and it was great. Having the symposium in such a unique setting was brilliant. It brought out the best in everyone. Oh, thank you, son, for going in. Bill cared about the environment and regularly donated to ACLU, the Democrats, and Planned Parenthood. He was a music lover and an artist, an avid gardener, a real Renaissance man. And these are some of the things we will remember him for. So although this is the last physical reminder we have of Bill, he has left us rich memories, and without trying, he somehow left behind the things he loved that now are a part of our lives, too. The music of Neil Diamond, John Denver, Roger Whittaker, and jellyfish are more a part of us now that he is no longer here to enjoy them. I promise you, Mr. Bill, you were loved, and you will never be forgotten. Now, Bill made it known, and this was the only thing he ever said about his final days, that he wanted the song Forest Lawn by John Denver played. So I have sheets, if you feel brave enough to sing along, we will sing Forest Lawn. And then after that, we will sing another favorite song that if you don't know it by heart, you're not related to me and Bill.
Oops, did I turn it off?
I'll take a sheet.
So some of the people will have to share. Who wants to give out?
I'll pass them out.
I already have one.
Thank you.
It's not the easiest song to sing.
You want to read over my shoulder?
Most people have never even heard of the song.
I know the song.
You know the song. Well,
yeah.
Then you have to sing.
Yeah. 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 Any more of them? Oh, here we go. Thank you.
Should I turn this off a little bit?
Sure.
And 16 liveried employees sell souvenirs from the funeral store. I wanna go simply when I go. They'll give me a simple funeral there, I know. With a casket lined in fleece and fireworks spelling out rest in peace. So take me when I'm gone to Forest Lawn. Oh, lay me down in Forest Lawn, they understand there. They have a heavenly choir, a military band there. Just put me in their care, I'll find my comfort there. With 16 planes and a last salute, they'll drop across in a parachute. I wanna go simply when I go. They'll give me a simple funeral there, I know. With 100 strolling strains and topless dancers with golden wings. Oh, take me when I'm gone to Forest Lawn. Church in the wild wood, kindly leave a contribution in the pail. Be as simple and as trusting as a child would, and we'll sell you the church in the dale. To find a simple resting place is my desire. Lay me down where the smiling face comes a little bit higher. My likeness cast in brass will stand in plastic grass, while hidden weights and springs tip its hat to the mourners filing past. I wanna go simply when I go. They'll give me a simple funeral there, I know. I'll lie beneath the sand with piped in tapes of Billy Graham. Oh, take me when I'm gone to Forest Lawn. Rock of ages, cleft for me. For a slightly higher fee. Oh, take me when I'm gone to Forest Lawn.
That was great.
Okay, now the other song. I think most of you know who love Bill, that Edelweiss was one of his very favorite songs. So without accompaniment, we're just going to do it, okay? Ruthie and Barry, do you want to start it off? You good voices.
Edelweiss, Edelweiss, every morning you greet me, small and white, clean and bright, you look happy to meet me. Blossom of snow, may you bloom and grow, bloom and grow forever. Edelweiss, Edelweiss, bless my homeland forever.
Amen.
I'm giving you guys a hand.
Come on, give yourself a hand. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Yes, yes. We're going to have those of you who have quotes to line up, and if you just line to my right and to your left here, you have quotes.
Okay. And just pass off the microphone just first.
Yes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So, I think Randy was one.
Okay.
Ellen, I am too, but I don't have my glasses, so maybe you can.
Okay, well, still stand with him. All right. And who, Melanie, and you two? I know, there was no good way to greet us.
Now let me say this. Let me say this to everyone, if you will. As you have your quote, we ask that when you finish your quote, you can go back to the space that you were in, and hand the mic off to the next person that's going to speak. But before we do that, I want us to give a round of applause. Pastor, wait a minute. Don't go anywhere. Don't go anywhere. I want us to give a round of applause to the pastor of the Scotch Plains Baptist Church that is with us and allowed us to be here today. Yes, indeed. Just a wonderful host, and we want to thank him from the bottom of our hearts. Yes, indeed.
I guess so, yeah.
All right.
One piece there in place.
Okay. There's no dress rehearsals. Yeah, okay. Please be very careful with that hole.
Yeah. Do they know what to?
Yeah, and then after you read your quote, put your flower in.
Yes.
Oh, where's my flower? Oops. And then after me, people can line up any order and just put your flower in.
Yes, after the quote, we ask that you put your flower, place your flower in, okay, and then return to your space. And then those after, the ones that have the quotes, if you will come and you can place your flowers if you wish. If you want to carry them home, you can do that too. I'm sure Ellen won't mind. Okay? All right. Let us start with the quotes now.
There was a man, and look, he is no more.
He died before his time.
The music of his life suddenly stopped.
A pity. There was another song in him.
Now it is lost forever.
Now it is lost forever.
I am of old and young, of foolish as much as the wise, regardless of others, ever regardful of others, maternal as well as paternal, a child as well as a man, stuffed with the stuff that is coarse and stuffed with the stuff that is fine.
I bequeath myself to the dirt to grow from the grass I love. If you want me again, look for me under your boot soles. You will hardly know who I am or what I mean, but I shall be good health to you nevertheless and filter and fiber your blood.
An honest man here lies at rest, as God with his image blessed.
The friend of man, the friend of truth, the friend of age, and guide of youth.
Few hearts like his with virtue warmed, few heads with knowledge so informed.
If there's another world, he lives in bliss.
If there's none,
he made the best of this.
Wow.
Do not stand at my grave and weep. I am not there. I do not sleep. I am a thousand winds that blow. I am the diamond glints on snow.
I am the sunshine on ripened grain. I am the gentle autumn rain. When you awake in the morning hush, I am the swift, uplifting rush.
Of quiet birds in circled flight, I am the soft stars that shine at night. Do not stand at my grave and cry. I'm not there. I did not die.
Death ends a life, not a relationship.
All the love you created is still there.
All the memories are still there.
You live on in the hearts of everyone you have touched.
And nurtured while you were here.
I'd like the memory of me to be a happy one. I'd like to leave an afterglow of smiles when the day is done.
I'd like to leave an echo, whispering softly down the ways, of happy times and laughing times and bright and sunny days.
I'd like to tears of those who grieve to dry before the sun, of happy memories that I leave behind when life is done.
In the end, it's not about how we die, but how we live.
We do not remember days, we remember moments. Don't cry because it's over, smile because it happened.
We are all stories in the end.
Only time and tears take great grief. That is what they're for. So it's true, when all is said and done, grief is the price we pay for love. I will not say, do not weep, for not all tears are an evil. The weird, weird thing about devastating losses, that life actually goes on.
He was my north, my south, my east, my west, my working week and my Sunday rest, my noon, my midnight, my talk, my song. I thought that love would last forever. I was wrong.
As we get to close, directly after the closing prayer.
Other people have to do their flowers.
Oh, don't, after the closing prayer, we'll have them to do this. Ellen, leave me alone. Just go on, sit down. Just sit down and be quiet. Bill, wherever you are, will you tell your wife to sit down? She reminds me of my own wife. Don't tell her I said so, please. After the closing prayer, you can come and place your flowers there and your memories. Can I say this? I was always pleased when I would speak at Temple Emmanuel, and Bill would be there. When he found out that I was a scientist also, you could see a smile on his face to see that there was a colleague in the crowd. All of us have our memories of him, and he will never die in our thoughts and in our minds. Every time we think about him, every time we remember a story that each of you have to share of your relationship with him, he still is alive in our hearts. And so let us always remember the good times, and always remember that time is not promised to any of us. So we have to live our life the fullest that we can each and every day, because we don't know if tomorrow will come and our number will be called. So today, we celebrate a life and not a death. Let us bow in a word of prayer. Precious God, our Father, we thank you for this time together with friends and relatives, this wonderful wife that has kept Bill alive, not only in her own heart, but has allowed us to share that love that we had for him. We thank you for all that have gathered in this place. Now our prayer is with the family, with this wife, with his children, with his relatives. We pray, dear Father, that you will ease their mourning. And dear Father, exchange it for joy, that every time they think about the good times, the laughter, the jokes, and all of the things that were pleasant in their lives, that they will remember Bill Ward. Now we ask your arms covering this family and friends, and dear Father, give them the peace that passeth all understanding. And we ask it in the name of our God. And the people said, amen.
Amen.
Come and join us, if you will, if you'd like to place your flowers there. And if those of you who want to keep them, I'm sure Ellen won't mind.
Is Nick still here?
Right behind you.